It's a forum to, I don't know if it has the title Black Lives Matter, but it is to look at that by way of reviewing two films in the festival, one of which is the Black Panther Party Vanguard of the Revolution, and the other is Concerning Violence, which is a documentary which tells us and shows us the words and the philosophy of Frantz Fanon. There is an individual racist act, or even a small group racist act. And when I say small, I don't literally mean tiny. I just mean a lesser number than the larger group. And then there are systemic forms of oppression. And the reason why nothing has changed is because those systems, that systemic illness, the systemic racism, the systemic sexism, hasn't changed. Waiting for the government, the president, the angels, and the somebody else to do it. We say we will support them, we will encourage them, we will tell them what mistakes we've made, honestly, instead of blaming them for not doing what they don't know to do. Well, the feeling is that Stanley Nelson and Lorenz Grant did a lot of homework. They made a great effort to interview people who ordinarily would not have been interviewed, and to take, to cull a piece of history, the trajectory of the Black Panther Party, as best they could, and make a two-hour piece out of it, which is kind of phenomenal. And of course I know that nobody can put 15, 16 years in 2 hours. And so there are all kinds of things that I would love to have seen, and I think it's upon someone else to do their movie. It was amazing. It was very difficult to watch, because it was the war that people waged for, so that future generations could thrive. And in the process of that war, people were killed and harmed. And so the two things, the Black Panther Party and those liberation struggles in South Africa and Mozambique as two examples, are so tied. It was really saddening to see the film, not because the words made me sad. The words were prophetic and accurate. They're Fanon's words. There was one I wanted to see today called Cuba. I don't live in Los Angeles, I live in Oakland. If I lived here, I would see everything I could.
Okay. Well, thank you, Erica, not just for speaking to me briefly, but for the work you've done and the work you continue to do, and your heart and love for the people, and we love you.